Good day, everyone, and welcome to the Personal Projects Fair of MYP Grade 10 students of Chiang Kai-shek College. In a little while, you will witness the products of our students' consolidation of learning through year-long inquiry and development of important ATL skills they'll need in both further education and life beyond the classroom. Through these projects, students develop confidence to become principled lifelong learners. To the parents and to the personal project supervisors, we thank you for the support you had extended to these students for the success of their projects. I myself have witnessed how they inquired and applied their ATL skills and developed to become independent learners. Apart from practicing and strengthening their approaches to learning skills, the personal project encourages students to develop an area of personal interest. The personal project provides an excellent opportunity for students to produce a truly personal and often creative product or outcome and to demonstrate a consolidation of their learning in the MYP. Thank you very much, and we hope you will enjoy the presentation of our students.
Congratulations, MYP students. MYP 的同学们，恭喜你们完成了自己的个人计划。For MYP students, personal projects are the culminating projects for you to demonstrate the ATL skills that you have learned and prove us that you are ready to move forward to the DP program. I believe looking back at the process, all of you will agree that the efforts you put in are worth it. I hope in this journey, you have understand that you have an active and constant role in your learning. It may not always seem like it, but you are in control of your own failure or success. Congratulations again, and see you in the DP program. 恭喜大家 ,DP 见了恭喜哦。
Hello everyone, I'm Erica Chua, one of the PP supervisors. My student Chen Yuanxiang will be presenting his topic, The Foldable House. He will be discussing about how he will be making a portable house for the homeless. Thank you.
Expectation. Reality. Haha.
Good day, everyone. So today you're gonna see what this product is and the process of making it. I turned this process into 7 big parts. Yeah, let's start.
Part 1.
This first part, I called it the investigation part. In there, I tried to find those inspirations for my final project. The goals, global context, and my prior knowledges. So first, let's start first with the inspiration part. Before actually deciding on making the house, I think of making a 3D science book and a workout routine. But then I want to make a house. Why? This is the story. It was a time where I was scrolling under a page, and that time I was finding inspirations of existing personal project examples. And I found a girl which personal project is making a homeless house for the dogs. And then quickly remember the homeless people under my house. They are really suffering from having no houses. So I want to help them. Therefore, I choose to make a house that can help those homeless people. Next up is the goal. So my goal is to help those homeless people. And also, don't forget, I want to improve my skills, especially those ATL skills and the skills in creating a product. Global context. So my chosen global context is scientific and technical innovation, because I want to use scientific innovations to help those people. Therefore, I choose this. Prior knowledges. So I actually found out that a lot of the subjects that I learned in school was closely related to my project, like math, science, art, and of course design. And on the other hand, ATL skills also help, like those researching skills, time management skills, and communication skills. Of course, don't forget that my origami skills, because I want my house to be foldable. Therefore, by using my origami skills, I can it can help a lot in the creation of the final product. Characteristics of my product. I almost forgot, but I want my product to be foldable, portable, minimal, recyclable, cheap, and mass producible, and it works as normal as a bed. Yeah, for those homeless people to be comfortable.
How to plan?
I call this part the plan part. Why? Because it simply is a part where I planned a lot, and also I researched to get familiarized with the field of the project, plans. So basically this part, I made a lot of calendars and set a lot of deadlines, and it was an overview of the project so that I can better understand what I'm going to do next. The research part. So basically in here, I research about those techniques and to familiarize myself in the field that I'm going to focus on. And I search those existing products of my competitors and to so that I can aim and improve their products, and to aim the characteristics that I made, though, like those eco-friendly, foldable, portable, those. Also in here, I did my process journal. Those important details, I all wrote it in here with pictures, of course. So, and this really helps me in the next part.
Part 3, Idea to Reality.
So this part, I called it Idea to Reality. Why? Because basically in here, I tried to change those ideas, like what I learned, those techniques, into real prototypes. Like make those sketches into real prototypes, like by using paper. Yes, and here I tried to experiment a lot of folding techniques, like this, and that. Like, and yeah, you'll be wondering, why don't I have the actual product? Why? Because my mom threw them.
Part 4, Selection.
So for this part, I called it the selection part. Why? Because basically, I just need to select the best prototype in those 10 prototypes that I've made, and make a sketch and the blueprint of it.
Part 5, Material.
The sixth part, I just called it the material part. Why? Yeah, it was just a time when I searched on the materials that I'll be needing. Like, what kind of cardboard do I use? What kind of sticking technique I'll be using? And of course, those materials should all fit the characteristics that I mean, like foldable and affordable. So the cardboard should be thin enough, well, to fold while not breaking easily. And also, it should be cheap.
Part 6, Transformation.
Finally, the seventh part, the transformation part. And this is what this part was the hardest. Why? Because I need to turn my idea into a real huge product. The process of it was also really difficult, so I turned them into 4 steps. Oh yeah, if you want to make a similar product to me, don't follow me, because this was a failure. You'll know why later. So the first step is to connect all the cardboards that I bought. Why? Because 200 times 280 centimeters cardboard aren't selling, and so I bought a lot of smaller cardboards and connect them using super glue and super tapes. The hard part is that when I turn them, the tape might fall out. The second step. So in here, I label down those lines, or I draw lines in the folding part so I know where I should be folding. And after that, I use a pencil to put pressure on the cardboard so it can cut off a little part of on top of the cardboard so that it will be easier to fold. Also, before actually deciding on using that technique, I also think of other techniques such as cutting the cardboard in half, and then I tape them so that it can fold. And also try to use a knife to cut a small depth on top of the cardboard so it can be easier to fold. But those two won't work at the end. Oh yeah, forgot to mention, the cardboard that I bought was really really thick, so it was really hard to fold if it was thick. And so I, after a long time of brainstorming, I decided to flatten the cardboard by stepping on it, which takes so much time because those cardboards are really big. After labeling down those lines, I can finally fold the cardboard, which was really 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 hard because the cardboard was still thick and hard to fold. Step 3, finally, after all those procedures, I can add the waterproof layer, and then I will connect each side. I will connect them by using super tape so that it can stand. And here, the worst part happened. I was lacking both tape, the super tape, and the waterproof layer. Even though I bought already 10 meters of them, I forgot to calculate how much I actually need beforehand, which leads to look like this. Finally, the last part, the fourth part. The fourth part is to try to fold the cardboard and make it fix, make the structure fix, of course. And it looks like this. Yes, we're done with all the process. So now we're gonna discuss about my reflection on the product and the process.
Criteria.
I made the criteria because I think criteria are really important, specifically in letting us to know what we should do and what we should prevent, and it also gives us a goal to focus on. Total made of 8 criteria for my product, so it can be more specific, and also 5 levels to score the criteria. First one is the comfortability of the product. So because I decided to make my product really big, like 180 × 80 cm. So I decided to give myself a score of 4. Another important criteria to be considered about is the safety. In my product, I've used tape and glue, and that was a little toxic for me because the smell was really bad. And therefore, I only received a score of 2. Next up is the cleanliness of the design. Forgot to mention, the product is actually really, really bad looking. Because in the process of making and folding the product, I've accidentally damaged the cardboard a lot of times, tearing it and making a lot of holes. Therefore, I only received a 2 score. That is the portability of the product. And to experiment this, I tried to let my 10-year-old sister carry the house, and the result came to that she can't. And I can only barely carry it. Therefore, I only received a score of 3. Of course, I need to consider if those people know how to use the product. And so I tried to teach my sisters and my mom to use the product, and the result came to that my sister can, but my mom can. My mom can. So I'll give myself a score of 3. The criteria is the lifespan of the product. Because I don't want to damage the product, I just try to fold and unfold the product, and it seems to be quite sturdy enough. So I received a score of 4. Of course, since my target audience was those homeless people, it should be really affordable. And the material cost of my product was around 300 plus, and adding my labor cost, it was around 400 plus to 500 plus, and I think it was really affordable for the homeless people still. So I gave myself a score of 4. The last criteria that I made was to test if the product is mass producible, because I should let more homeless people use this product. And by my own hands, using my own power, I can finish the product in under 12 hours. But if there's the help of machines, if possible, it might be created in just a minute, because you'll just need to cut, stick, and fold the product. So I think I received a score of 4.5. Oh, after calculating the average of the score, I got a score of 3.5 out of 5. And I think this was lower than my expectation, because I think I can get a 4 on average, but it was still a good experience. Finally, the reflection part. In here, I reflect a lot on my actions, on my decisions, and a lot of regression came, such as why didn't I use recyclable plastic instead of cardboard, because it might bend easier, and why didn't I bought more tape beforehand, like thinking and calculating the tape that I'll be needing beforehand. But I still think this is a good experience for me, because I'm still in the process of learning it, because I'm just a beginner, and I believe that failure leads to success, and by experiencing different kinds of difficulties, I can know how to reduce them, therefore getting a higher score next time.
Knowledge and understanding.
Yeah, in here, I think I have achieved my goal in getting experience in this new part of field, and I realized the importance of the ATL skills, and a big important and good thing is that I know how I can use the knowledge that I learned from the school and apply them in my real life situation. And if there's a second generation product, maybe I will know how to I will exactly know how I can improve them, like by not doing the same mistakes again.
Development
as an IT learner. Yes, this experience has a significant impact on my future, and like having improved almost all of my skills, I know exactly how I can do better in almost any task in the next time. And I realize how important making plans are, like considering every single aspect, and by now I value my time much more. Overall, I think the best thing I got from this project is that I have finally achieved my goals, which is to help the human society with my knowledges and giving the most basic needs to the homeless people. Thank you all for watching until here. Yeah, you might be wondering what I'm looking. Yeah, this was just my report, not my script.
Thank you.
Hi everybody! Louis Armstrong once wrote that music is life itself. Do you agree? Well, the answer would be a resounding yes for the next personal project presenter you are going to witness today. With a lot of dedication, hundreds of hours of work, and countless practice, this rock star is the next big thing in music. Gwyneth C. Chua today is going to show you life through her music as she plays the melody of some of her favorite songs growing up with the strings of her guitar. Yes, the lovely Gwyneth and her project on learning the guitar will showcase for us today the fruit of her hard work. Sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Good day everyone! I am Gwyneth Lois Pisichu, a grade 10 student of CKS College in IB Middle Years program. What made me interested in my topic is because I want to try playing a guitar since we have one here, but I don't usually play because I don't know how. I am interested in playing guitar because it looks interesting. My family and close relatives also know how to play guitar. So I was inspired by them, and I was also inspired by the young children I watch on YouTube.
So first is planning, which includes the title of the project, the goal of the project, global context, and why you chose this project.
The title of my project is This Acoustic Guitar. My goal is to learn how to strum and pluck properly, so I decided to cover some easy-to-play Disney songs. The global context that I chose is personal and cultural expression. Music comes in different forms. It expresses one's emotion and creativity. It has been a part of our culture and has influenced us in many ways. The reason why I chose this project is that I find playing guitar interesting. Seeing and hearing people motivated me to learn how to play the guitar, and it makes me want to more get better at it.
Next is investigating, which contains what criteria did you use developing and assessing your project process, and how did you practice self-management?
Here are the criteria that I use for developing and assessing my product. The first is mastery of instrument, which is 30%. Next is the choice of song, which is 20%. Then the message of song, 10%. The singing quality is 20%. And lastly, the arrangement for 20%. The project progress or the timeline that I made is that starting from September 19, I will start with practice for plucking, and on October 1, I will start to practice the other two songs, and by November, I will try to sing and play the guitar at the same time, and on to December 22, I will start filming. By January, I will edit the videos I took. I practice self-management by making a schedule that every Saturday and Sunday at noon or in evening, I will practice my guitar for 2 to 4 hours.
Next is taking action. Show and explain your product, how did your product answer your inquiry question, and how is the product related to global context.
For the final output, I covered 3 Disney songs from 3 different movies. The first song I covered is Can You Feel the Love Tonight from the movie Lion King. I used the guitar as my instrumental and sang along to the tune. So here's the video.
Can
The second song is You'll Be In My Heart from the movie Tarzan. I decided not to sing along so that I could focus more on plucking. Here it goes. Is I Can See the Light from the movie Tango.
Thank you.
Likewise, in the second song, I only play the guitar to showcase my guitar playing skills. My first inquiry question is, how can I learn plucking within a month or year? At first, I thought that I would be able to learn plucking within a month or year because it's hard, but in the end, I was able to do it within 2 months, though I still need improvement. So I learned plucking within a month by watching YouTube and accompanying him to play the guitar. The second question is, would playing all the albums be easy for me? From the experience I had doing this project, I would say that playing all the albums wasn't that easy because you have to know all the chords and know how to sing the song. The third question is, would it be easy for me to memorize all the songs? From the project, I guess I memorized all the chords easily and I practiced twice a week for 2 to 5 hours. And on to the final question, since I only know basic chords, will it be easy for me to learn new chords? It answered my question because it was kind of hard at first to learn new chords, but as time went by, it was kind of easy, but my strumming still needs improvement. My product is related to the global context because, as I said a while ago, music expresses one's emotion and creativity, and from my personality, I express myself through music.
Last is reflection, evaluation of product based on criteria. What did you learn? How did you feel about your product? And how did you improve as an IB learner?
From the criteria that I've chosen, mastery of instrument, which is 30%, I would give myself a grade of 28% because I'm confident that I have mastered all the chords in guitar. Next is the choices of song, which is 20%, and I would give myself a total of 16% because for me, the songs I chose are good and very relaxing to hear, and the songs I chose were based on my favorites. The message of the song is 10%. For this criteria, I would give myself a grade of 8% because the message of the song has a deep meaning and I know that everyone knows this song and we would understand this song, especially our situation today. Like, we all should love the people around us and love yourself, guys. And next is the singing quality, which is 20%. For this, I will give myself 15% because I'm not that good at singing. And I'm also not confident in my voice. And last is arrangement, that is 20%. I will give myself 15% because the location where I film is kind of scattered. There is no certain place to film and some parts in the videos are against the light. So the total score of this is 82%. What I learned from this project is that playing the instrument you're interested in is fun and you will enjoy it because you will learn a lot, even though at first you will have a hard time, but if you keep on going, you will get better at it. I also learned that you need patience to play the guitar to achieve the song you wanted to play, because if not, you'll get tired and find a new song. It will be such a waste for you to practice, and in the end, you'll find it difficult and find a new song. For the final product, I feel proud to be able to finish my 3 videos, but at the same time, I am not confident in my skills. But I'm really happy to see the outcome of how many months of practice. As an IB learner, research skills are my weakness, but I think my research skills improve a lot because I have to research for guitar tutorials that are equal to my skills and not that hard, not that easy, just average. My time management and balance also improve because I manage to balance my time for personal project and schoolworks. Before I end this video, I would like to share my experiences throughout the year of doing this product. I've encountered unexpected challenges throughout my practice, such as my finger had callus, having a hard time to pluck because sometimes I pluck the wrong string, and my strumming isn't that really good. So yeah, my overall experiences during this project was really great, although sometimes I feel stressed, overthinking, and pressured. I felt happy when I was slowly making progress, and I never thought I would reach this point from all the challenges I've been through. After completing this project, it occurred to me that it is really a challenge to try to balance your academics and your project within the given time. That's all. Thank you for listening.
C.S. Lewis wrote, "You can make anything by writing." An old proverb also once quoted that if you want to be remembered in this world even after you're gone, be a writer. Write, share, and influence. Writing is not an easy passion.
it requires time, a lot of it, patience, perseverance, and a lot of creativity partnered with endless research. Today, I am very happy to present to you a writer in the making, one whose passion I have witnessed firsthand, whose improvement and dedication I have seen from the beginning to the end of her book, her very first, Behind the Camera. Now, if you are looking for a fresh read, this novelette from her personal project is an absolute winner. Please welcome Sidelt Sim.
My personal project, Behind the Camera, a novelette, was a project very challenging to do. It made me learn more things about myself, develop different skills, and experience things I would never imagine doing. What was the objective of my personal project, you may ask? Well, the objective was to write and finish a novelette. The title of my project, Behind the Camera, a novelette, is based off the title of my written novelette, which is Behind the Camera. I discovered my passion for writing back in June of the year 2019. I read Michael Thomas Ford's young adult novel, Suicide Notes, and the story hit me like a truck. The novel showed the fine line of being normal and not normal. It was a valuable realization. However, not only did the message affect me, but the delivery of the message was beautiful. He did not tell the message, he showed it. Because of that, I aspired to write stories and experiment with the beauty of literature. I started writing a few days after finishing the novel and developed my writing skills. Becoming an author was not something I strive to be in the future. But during my writing phase, I have always dreamed of writing a full novel. When we were given the opportunity to pick anything we want for a personal project, writing a novel was my first option and I took it. I wanted my novelette to create an impact towards readers like how Suicide Notes impacted me. Hence, I made it my goal to make a novelette that would convey a meaningful message to the readers. I wanted to answer the question, how can I use novelettes to send a clear and impactful message to my readers? Since one of my goals for this personal project is to send an impactful message with a novelette. I want to know how much a novelette would impact the readers because those are what authors use to communicate themselves with. I created a criteria that would help me assess my final product. I decided to use the percentage method to grade myself, having all criteria sum up to 100%. The largest strand for my criteria is the content of the novelette, which includes the story plot, elements of a story, character development, and conflict, having taken up 30% of 100%. Next is the language for 25%. This strand includes grammar, use of English, punctuation, and spelling. Creativity is worth 20%, and within the strand is creative elements, story twists, and originality. Organization is 15% and includes coherence, transition, and consistency. Lastly, layout for 10% includes the book cover, blurb, page layout, and the overall appearance of the novel. To be able to keep track of my progress, I made a timeline to make sure I do not lose my way throughout the project. The timeline I devised was sure to consider obstacles that may block me from writing. I made sure to exclude all of the dates of when summatives are happening so I can focus on those for the time being. But I also made sure I had enough time to write and finish the novelette. Starting August, I brainstormed for a plot and planned out how many characters the book would have. I started writing from September onwards and wrote for at least 2 hours every day. I also have a process journal to help jot down the things I have learned throughout the entirety of the project. In the journal are the sources used, meeting activities I had with my supervisor, and casual updates on the progress of my novelette. My self-management skills were tested in many ways through this project. The writing part was a given. Novelette writing is a task that requires a lot of time and commitment, and looking for free time to write when having a lot of things to do is quite a challenge. I practiced the said skill by doing my best to follow my schedule, always make time for writing, and make sure to actually get some content in. I'm a person who finds it difficult to focus on a specific task, so when I focused solely on writing without getting distracted, it was a big improvement in my self-management skills. The final outcome of my personal project is a hardbound hard copy of my written novelette. The front cover was digitally hand-drawn, and the blurb was originally written by me. In the novelette are 15 chapters, an acknowledgement note, and an about the author page at the back. A little overview of the plot of Behind the Camera is a story about a senior year main lead who lived a simple life with the only objective of graduating with flying colors. Her school then got sponsorship from a successful reality television show company, and she and her friends were obliged to join the casting. She was not in favor of joining the show, but to her dismay, got casted anyway. She expected everything to run smoothly because, after all, it was a very successful company, but it did not go as she expected. My final product answered the inquiry questions through the content of the novelette. I was able to answer these questions by writing a novelette that conveyed a clear and impactful message. I made sure that the message of the story would reach the readers with clarity, and I was able to do so by first understanding what the message would be. Once that was done, I had to use my writing skills effectively and properly deliver the message. After reading my novelette a few times, I can say that the message was clearly delivered with impact. My novelette storyline was interesting enough to get readers hooked on the book, and it was organized neatly, having all small details connected to each other to make a big picture. During the planning, I had to know who my target audience were so my novelette would be able to reach them. Since my target audience would be teenagers around my age, I decided the plot would center around the last year of high school so they would be able to relate to the story. The suited global context that I use for this personal project is personal and cultural expression. The meaning of this phrase is to discover and express ideas, feelings, and beliefs while developing and enjoying our creativity at the same time. Novel writing is a way to express feelings through words and for writers to enjoy and explore their creative freedom. For this reason, I picked this global context because I want to express my feelings and ideas and explore further with my creativity in the literary world. We were assigned to evaluate our final product, aligning it to the created criteria stated above. The novelette has an original plot, great character development as time went on, all of the elements of a story were used effectively, and the conflict was explicitly visible. However, the character development for some characters could have been improved further if I was able to write more chapters, since the transition of one of the character's cheerful to dark aura was not that smooth. Because of this, I gave myself a grade of 28%. As one of my main goals when planning for this was to improve my grammar and expand my vocabulary, as my English was not perfect, I did a lot of research for different terminologies and using punctuation marks effectively, and I applied them to the novelette. Since I have seen improvement in my grammar and the placing of punctuation marks, I give myself a grade of 21%. For the plot solely came from my imagination, it had many original and creative elements in it. The story twists were something people wouldn't really expect, but it lined up with the whole plot. For these reasons, I give myself a grade of 20%. The transitions of one chapter to another was flawless. The story flow was consistent, and the coherence of the story was well made. However, I feel like I could have done a little bit better with the consistency of the wording choice. Maybe if I pinned down the emotions of the characters more, then I could have chosen better terms to describe certain scenarios or feelings. For those reasons, I give myself a 14%. The book cover was beautifully made and the blurb amazingly formatted. The pages were properly laid out and the overall appearance of the book is stunning. Because of these factors, I give myself a 10% for this criterion. Adding all of the grades I gave myself in each strand for the final product, in total I received the grade of 93 out of 100%. Through this project, I was able to learn to better manage myself to get things done quicker. I picked up new words during the writing process, and writing dialogues have become easier for me to write. Through various sources regarding writing, I found different strategies to indulge readers and make them keep turning the pages. I realized that research is the key to everything, from how to write a novelette, to what kind of clothes would a professional wear, to good food with coconut in it. I feel incredibly accomplished since I never thought I could finish a 15-chapter novelette within a span of 6 months. It feels like a dream come true to be able to hold a hard copy of a novelette that I put my blood, sweat, and tears into. I also feel really proud of myself because the outcome came out better than expected and reached all of the strands of the created criteria. As an IB learner, there are certain ATL skills that must be developed and learner profiles to use. With this project, we were able to enhance these skills and learner profiles. I saw improvement in all of my ATL skills, especially self-management and research skills, which were some of my weakest ones. Using all of the IB learner profile, I was able to reach points I thought I was not able to, like writing more openly and communicating the message of my novelette more effectively. Overall, making this personal project was an amazing experience, having been able to know more about myself in depth and take on my passion for writing was a great opportunity for me. Because of this project, I was able to further improve my writing skills and make my dream come true. One day, I will look back at this project and remember the long and challenging process to completing the novelette, but it was worth doing. This is an experience that I will never forget. Thank you.
Ralph Waldo Emerson wrote, "Every artist was first an amateur." The personal project presentation you are going to witness today is the work of a student who learned the art of crochet from scratch, built her works repeatedly, and perfected her craft through practice. Come and be amazed by the handiworks of L. Julian C. as she presents today her crochet project.
Interviewing you today, so start off by introducing yourself.
So hello, my name is L. Julian C. from 10AA, and today I will be talking about my personal project.
So L, first question, what was your goal here?
My goal here was to learn how to crochet. I originally planned on learning how to sew to make reworked clothes, but I feel like the equipments were too expensive and time-consuming, so I stuck with crocheting.
Why did you choose crochet?
To be honest, I came across a few TikToks about crocheting and I found it really cute. And then I realized I had a few friends who knew how to crochet, so I was like, oh, there are other people who will be able to guide me throughout my journey here.
What happened during the process? Were there any challenges?
There were definitely a lot of challenges, but I was able to overcome it. A really big help was when I joined a crocheting community in the Philippines on Facebook, and that's where I learned that there are so much different types of yarns there, and they also gave tips on how to do different stitches. And also Instagram, where I was able to see different products of what people posted there, and I was also able to get free patterns.
What were your struggles along the journey?
So the first one is that I had no knowledge about anything about crochet. I was a literal newbie, and I ordered the wrong yarns at first because they were too thin, but I relied on YouTube on most of the parts because there were a lot of varieties on which tutorials I can follow. And the others are learning new stitches because I have to keep practicing it. And I have a lot of failed projects. I wasted a lot of yarn, but I learned a lot through them.
Were you on time with your timeline? If so, how did you practice self-management?
Surprisingly, I was with my timeline the whole process. I was able to meet every step that I wrote down from the beginning, And I feel like I was able to do it because I enjoyed what I was doing at that time. So yeah.
Your final output, what are the criteria you came up with?
For my final output, I came up with 4 different criteria, namely appearance, process, consistency, and meaning. Appearance because it's the first thing that everyone will see. Process because just to make sure that I was the one who made it. Consistency because there are different kinds of stitches, just to make sure that there are no holes in my project. And meaning because when I did some research, I saw how most of it were just like cute stuff and I wanted it to have a unique touch to my final output.
When you mentioned about meaning and your criteria, what was your final outcome?
So for my final outcome, I decided to make a bucket hat. I know it's simple, but I made it for my grandmother who's in Canada. She really likes wearing hats and I decided to make one for her. Also, the color is red, which is something she wouldn't wear because most of her hat colors are black, blue, brown, and white.
How did the bucket hat answer your inquiry question, which was how would you make a product that could impress?
So my product is super simple actually. It's a simple bucket hat that any beginners would do once they learn the basics of crocheting. But I made it because I wanted it to have a meaning and something that would be able to be really close to home. And I was able to create also my own pattern at the end because I didn't like the other patterns, which makes my product really unique. Also, I realized that there are other projects that I could do before the final project. So I was able to make a jacket, a simple shirt, different plushies, and more bucket hats.
Your global context was personal and cultural expression, right? How did your personal product relate to the context?
So, most of the projects that I made says a lot about me because there are millions of patterns out there that I could use, but I chose the ones that looked cute. And also, recently I have been using more thicker yarns to make plushies because that's what I really enjoy using over the ones that require a lot more patience because the yarns are thinner and the hooks used are thinner.
Last few questions. How well does your product fare against your criteria?
I believe that I was able to give justice in all 4 of my criterias because it's seen in my project that I was able to be consistent, for it to have meaning, and the appearance is also really cute.
How did you learn from completing the project?
Throughout this project, it was testing my patience because I had to unravel the whole project once I have the wrong number of stitches. And also, I also learned how to communicate more because I had to talk to sellers and I had to ask patterns from other people. I was also able to hone my researching skills because I had to do everything from scratch, and also able to improve my self-management because I was able to go with my timeline this whole time.
Last question. How do you feel as an IB learner about the success of your project?
To be honest, I'm really, really proud of myself because I didn't think that I would be able to pull this project off, because knowing that I had zero knowledge about crocheting in the start, it really gave me a sense of achievement. Also, because of this, I was also able to improve my sewing because I needed to sew different parts of the body. Now that I know a lot about it and I can create my own patterns. Also, I'm thankful for my advisor, Mrs. Aliana Felix, because she was able to guide me throughout this whole process. We'd always meet during Wednesdays and she'd ask my progress check, which was a big help to me because this pushed me to create progress every week before we meet. So I'm also thankful for the friends I was able to ask in the start on where to buy yarns and what they recommended. So yeah, that's it for my interview. I hope you guys enjoyed. Bye-bye!
According to Miley Cyrus, we belong to the music. And according to Florida Georgia Line, music is healing. Now, according to Ashley Kiara Tang, love yourself to turn your flower back in shape, turn back, and then you escape, burn back, start new trails. This personal project presentation you are going to watch next is The Birth of a Star, the opening of a door for a music protege, a rock star, an angel, a new generation singer of our very own. I proudly present to you Ashley Kiara Tang and her song composition project.
Hi, this is my personal project, composing a song. So why did I choose this as my personal project? It has the interests and hobbies involved with just singing. And my goal is to be able to compose my own song that brings out a clear message to everyone. The global context that I chose for this project is personal cultural expression. It is how we express ourselves through experiences, ideas, cultures, beliefs, and many more. So this is the criteria that I made on based on how I wanted to be graded. So we have message of the song, melody of the song, audience impact, music video quality, and music video relevance. So for a total of 100%, I divided it based on how confident I am on those parts. So for the message of the song, 35%, 10% for the melody of the song, 20% for audience impact, 20% for music video quality, and 15% for music video relevance. So this is the timeline that I made. So September 2 to 4 is this song question suggested by the title or topic. September 7 to 8 is choose the song structure. September 9 to 11 is assign each question to a part of the song, verses, chorus, and many more. September 14 to 25 is making of lyrics. September 28 to October 1, double checking and revision of lyrics. October 5 to 22 is finding and making of the melody and chords of the song. October 26 to 30 is rehearsal of the song. November 2 to 6 is recording of song. November 9 to 13, editing of song audio. November 16 to 20, planning for MV and cover photos. November 23 to December 3 is filming of MV and photoshoot for cover. December 4 to 11 is editing of MV. And December 14 to 16 is finalized. So how did I practice self-management? So I was able to practice self-management because I made a timetable or a timeline. So that also helped a lot. So now we are going to the step before the music video. So the topic that I chose is self-love. Why did I choose self-love? It is because I believe that there are a lot of people out there who don't love themselves enough. And this could be a serious issue. It could lead to mental problems and stuff. So the title of the song is Petals. So the general message is, flowers die because one doesn't pay attention to them and just let their petals fall off and eventually wither. It's just like loving yourself. If you don't pay much attention to yourself, your petals will start to fall. So the song structure that I chose is ABABCBB or verse, chorus, bridge, chorus, chorus. And this is my lyric. Verse 1. Pre-chorus, chorus, verse 2, bridge, and now we are moving on to the song teaser.
Down like pebbles seen in town. Love yourself to turn your flower back in shape. Turn back, and then you escape. Then burn track, start new trails. Don't lay yourself in like you're inside a jail. Give your petals the freedom to shine. 'Cause they are yours, not theirs or mine.
So now we are going to the raw audio of the song.
What if I tell you that flowers need petals to live? Would you even trust me? and take care of your petal. If it's a rain outside and your flower needs water, would you give it a pull to make sure that it is safe? Petals make you glow, glow, glow. Use the rain, show, show, show. They are part of you, you, you. Don't lose the link. Petals, petals, why do you fall down? Like pebbles, pebbles seen in town. Love yourself to turn your flower back in shape. Turn back and then you escape. Then burn tracks on your trails. Don't let yourself feel like you're inside a jail. Give your petals the freedom to shine. Cause they are yours, not theirs or mine. What if I inform you that petals are part of you? And once they start to fall, you will surely lose it all. If it's the only way to make you wake up your dream, then I will be the one to be the wicked queen. Petals make you glow, glow, glow. Use the red and show, show, show. They are part of you, you, you. Don't lose them like ooh. Petals, petals, why do you fall down? Like pebbles, pebbles seen in time. Love yourself to turn your flower back in shape. Turn back and then you escape. Then burn tracks down your trails. Don't let yourself feel like you're inside a jail. Give your petals the freedom to shine. Cause they are yours, not theirs or mine. Roses taught me how to love. Daisies showed me to move on. Iris showed me that there's hope. A flower taught me how to be me. Now it's your time to find your message. It's your turn to learn how to love yourself. Petals, petals, why do you fall down? Like pebbles, pebbles seen in town. Love yourself to turn your flower back in shape. Turn back and then you escape. Then burn tracks down your trail. Don't let yourself feel like you're inside a jail. Give your petals the freedom to shine. Cause they are yours, not theirs or mine. Petals, petals, why do you fall down? Like pebbles, pebbles seen in town. Love yourself to turn your flower back in shape. Turn back and then you escape. Then burn tracks down your trails. Don't let yourself feel like you're inside a jail. Give your petals the freedom to shine. Cause they are yours, not theirs or mine.
So next is the cover photo that I made.
Now it's time for the final product, which is the music video.
What if I tell you that flowers need petals to live? Would you even trust me and take care of your petals? If it's a rain outside and your flower needs water, would you give it up for to make sure that it is safe? Petals make you glow, glow, glow. Use the rush, oh, show, show. They are part of you, you, you. Dust to make oh, oh, oh. Petals, petals, why do you fall down? Like petals, petals seen in time. Love yourself to turn your flower back and shine.
Compose your own original song. So I was able to answer this through experience and of course research. So here is the set research. So it is how to write a song in 10 steps. So first, start with the title. Second, make a list of questions suggested by the title. Third, choose a song structure. Fourth, choose a question to answer in the course of each. Fifth, find the melody in your lyrics.
6, begin to add chords to your chorus melody. 7 is work on the lyric in your first verse. 8 is connect your verse and chorus. 9 is build your second verse and bridge. And the last one is complete and heard your song. So how does my product or outcome relate to the global content? So the global content that I chose is personal and cultural expression, and how we express ourselves, our ideas, cultures, beliefs, and then more. And I believe that when you write your own song or compose your own song, it involves those. Like when you write the lyrics, you need to write down your thoughts, your ideas, your point of view on certain things. So now it's time for my reflection. So we're starting with the self-evaluation based on the criteria that I made earlier. So we have message of the song, and then melody of the song, audience impact, music video quality, and music video relevance. So for a total of 35%, the message of the song, I gave myself 33%. I gave myself 33% because I think that the message is pretty clear and it is understandable. Like if you would read the lyrics or listen to the song, I think it's pretty clear. For the melody of the song, total of 10%, I gave myself 6%. Because I don't really play any instruments, and I think that there was something special with my melody. But I think it's fine for the first timer. And then audience impact, total of 20%, I gave myself 17%, because as far as I can remember, I got like a total of 600 views. And then my music video quality, total 20%, I gave myself 15%, because I think that it was okay, it was good. And the music video relevance, total of 15%, I gave myself 14%, because I think it's pretty relevant to see the connection of the song to the music video itself. And the total of all of these are a total of 86%. So next, what did I learn? So okay, I learned a lot from this project, like how you properly compose my own song or your own song, like suggested by the inquiry question too. And it is pretty fun experiencing it because there's a lot of things I've said before, like on how you write your own lyrics, you have to list some questions and do the verses, the part of the song, and I think that's pretty interesting. And then how do you feel about my product? So of course I do feel proud for composing my own song, because it's also my first song. That's all. And then how did I improve as an idea? So I think my thinking skills improved since you have to think a lot in this project. Like what is the concept, what concept you want, how does the cover photo look like, what is the story in the music video, and many more. And that's all. Thank you for listening to my presentation.